Okay, how many? Three chairs. No.
Allah.
It's coming, eh?
Hey.
Thank you. Time. Okay. Thank you. The Black Stars of Ghana are taking on the Cranes of Uganda. The game is currently tied. In commentary position is myself, Kosifiaka, assisted by Mr. Randy Haji. So far it's been a very, very cagey encounter between the two teams. And the Black Stars line up this way. They line up in a 4-3-3 formation. Anan Opoku, Eric Addo, Edmond Addo, and Dennis Odoi make up the back four. In front of Jojo Walakos, who is in between the sticks. Abdul Salid Samed, Ernest Nyama, and Francis Abu make up a midfield trio. And those tasked to find the goals for the Black Stars are Jordan Ayu, Antoine Semenyo, and Abdul Fatahu Isha Haku. It's already 23 minutes late at the start, Marrakesh. The Black Stars are currently in possession of the ball at the back. That goal from the Black Stars came from Jerome Opoku, and the Ugandan Cranes equalized from the spot. So the Black Stars currently in possession. Mohamed Abu gives the ball to Ernest Nwama, who is very nimble footed, plays that to the right. Abdul Fatah Ishaku on the ball. He shoots. Will he find the net? Unfortunately, he doesn't. The Black Stars have started all over again. Randy. I mean, a lot of Ghanaians looking at this Black Stars lineup have wondered why Otto Addo still prefers to play Edmond Addo at centre back.
You watch the game so far. Definitely, the pace is quite slow. Probably, maybe due to the weather condition. But again, with the question you just asked, I think that probably this is a new team that Otto wants to put up. He's tried and tested quite a number of these players in the past, and he will certainly want to keep a core of them. And mind you also that he's just building a team up, and of course, you should be expecting some of these things. Most importantly, when we know that this is actually a friendly match. So no two ways about it, he's building a team. If we want him to continue with this pace, then that is it. We have to give him the leverage to continue.
The Black Stars on the attack. Jordan Ayew on the ball on the left flank. He dribbles one and turns, and he takes the ball back again to the center circle. Finds Abdul Salih Samed, who doubles on it a little bit, gives the ball back to Edmond Addo, who intricately gives the ball back to Abdul Salih Samed. And Mohamed Abu on the ball. The Black Stars are exchanging possession. They are keeping some very, very, very good possession in this game. The ball goes again to Mohamed Abu. Who is he going to find? He takes it back to Edmond Addo once again, back to defense. Abdul Salih Samed takes it to the left flank of the Black Stars. The ball is currently being pinged around in the middle of the park. The Ugandans are keeping a very, very, very good shape. What can they do? Are they looking to hit the Black Stars on the counter? Otto Addo is very, very pensive on the touchline. The Ugandans line up this way. They have Ikara in post. Bomono, Stibik, and Mugabe, not Robert Mugabe, make up the back. For Mato, Seminkula, Mutayaba, and Mukwala, who found that goal from the penalty spot, make up that midfield. And Bayo is the sole man in attack. So it is a very fierce game as we do go along. The Black Stars seem to be in control of possession. Currently, the stats are favoring them. They currently have a little over 60% of the ball as compared to that 39% that the Ugandan Cranes currently do have. So as we can see, this is another set piece. This game seems to be one that will be settled on set pieces, and it seems a very controversial penalty. And Jordan Ayew takes the ball, places it on the spot. Randy, Jordan Ayew has been very clinical from the penalty spot.
I think that that's actually his one of his strengths when it comes to playing on the field, because even in the throughout the Black Stars tournament, if you recall, even the AFCON, we had a couple of kicks from the spot that he had to take as well. I think one of his strengths has to do with what he does as far as the set pieces are concerned. But we are playing against Uganda, And definitely the Black Stars should take a lead in this game assistance. Though.
Definitely. So Jordan Ayew stands on the spot. He helps, he puffs, he moves, and he puts it away. Jordan Ayew for the Black Stars. 2-1 to the Black Stars of Ghana. The Cranes have it all to do.
And that's
once again
to write your name emphatically when you're playing against more or less like Minos in the game. And of course, Ghana shouldn't be at par at all with Uganda. Looking at the depth of players we have in our setup, definitely Ghana should be up in too many goals as it stands now.
Definitely. So there's quality oozing through the Black Stars. And bear in mind that the Ugandan team led by Paul Pot lost by 4-0 against Comoros in their last friendly. So they do have a lot of amends to make in this one. But currently 28 minutes played at Stade de Marrakech, and the Black Stars of Ghana have their noses in front. 2-1, courtesy a Jordan Ayew penalty. So the Ugandans would want to come back from the dead. They are currently in possession. The ball goes out for a throw-in to the Cranes of Uganda. I'm sure everybody in Kampala will be very glued to this game, hoping for a miracle considering the form of the Black Stars League. The Black Stars on the attack. Ernest Norma, what can he do? Absolutely nothing. He runs into a brick wall. The ball is in the center of the pitch. Fantastic midfield play. The ball goes to the right side to Bayo. What is he going to do? He doubles on it. He's looking for his man. Doesn't seem to be able to find his man. The Black Stars are keeping their shape very well. Are they going to be penetrable? Cross from the right side. A fantastic chance in the box. He shoots. And oh my God, he shoots wide. That was quite wide.
A poor finishing. I mean, he could have done better.
Definitely.
We were able to control the ball. Took out two or three defenders standing right behind you. I mean, it's just about placing the ball. Why would he even go for power when you're already in the 18-yard box? Placement would have been far better than what he did anyway.
Definitely. Mutiaba couldn't make use of that chance. He puts that very, very well wide. The Black Stars are building up from the back. Once again, from the right side to the middle, Edmond Adu with that ball to Jerome Opoku with a goal, the first goal scorer for the Black Stars. They plot it among themselves. What is Jerome going to do? Stepping out of the defense. Abdul Salih Samed, the man who is playing the register role tonight at the center of the Ghana midfield, takes it back again to Edmond Adu. Is he going to go long? No, he doesn't. He goes to the right side of the pitch. Mohamed Abu, who has been very pivotal in this midfield. The man they call the professor gives it back to Mohamed Abu. The Black Stars currently are controlling possession against the Cranes of Uganda. He goes long, looking for Abdul Salih Samed. He finds him somehow, fortuitously. That ball goes back. The Black Stars are looking to build something, but the Cranes of Uganda are very, very resolute. They look to be keeping their shape. Paul Put must have done an amazing tactical job with the Ugandan national team. Edmond Adu with the ball. Who does he find? He takes it back to his defensive partner in Jerome, who found that goal for the Black Stars. Jojo Walakot looks long. Who will he find? Well, all he can find is the throw-in for the Black Stars. I mean, looking at this Moroccan setup, Randy, do you think they have what it takes to come back, especially since they are playing well? Abdul Fattah Ishaku on the right side. Who is he going to find? Is he going to cross it in? He does, but he finds absolutely nobody. Nobody's in the box.
No, you have three players in the 18-yard box. What else do you have to float that ball far off the main target? You have three people in the 18-yard box. I mean, just ship the ball to them.
So you should have been more
measured.
There
was too much power on the ball. Yes, you should have just measured them. I mean, there was too much power on the ball. If you could have a replay of it, you realize that there was too much power on the ball when he floated it. I mean.
So Abdul Fattah Ishaku should have done better. A lot of people have said, listen, he's growing as a football player. He plays for Leicester City this season. He's having an absolutely storming season for the Foxes in England. So the ball is still with the Ghanaian contingent. They seem to be having a lion's share of the possession. Ernest Nyama with the ball. He passes that one into the box. Who is going to go? Jordan Ayew, who's playing in the hole, can't do anything with it. Back to the man they call the Professor, Dennis Odoi. He's trying to recycle possession for the Black Stars of Ghana. He takes it back all the way. Mohamed Abu gives that ball to Edmond Adu. Edmond Adu, Jerome Opoku goes long. He's looking for the lone man in front. He finds Antoine Semenyo, who cannot control that ball. He gives it away to the Ugandans, who eventually win a free kick in their own half. A chance for them to get a breather, because the Black Stars have been absolutely all over them, Randy.
The last 5 minutes has been quite intense. The pressure from the Black Stars being piled on the cranes of Uganda looks quite hard and tough for the defenders to work hard or extra hard in defending. But I feel that the Black Stars are taking too much chances. They are actually wasting too much chances. They should be punishing the Ugandans as it stands now, because they seem to create more chances. The last touches in the last third becomes a major problem with them, if they can just correct all of that. Because mind you, a lot of people are having their eyes glued on this particular game. It makes a lot, it means a lot to Ghanaians in this crucial period.
Definitely, the Cranes seem to have a crucial kick of the ball in the half of the Ghanaians. They are passing that very intricately. Absolutely fantastic backflip. And what are they going to do? Is it going to go into the box? The Cranes are finding a foothold, and that was a terrible shot from the Cranes of Uganda. But what's happening? So that was the penalty. We are taking you back to all the action. So Ghana took the lead through Jerome Opoku, who headed in from Jordan Ayew's cross from the corner spot. The Ugandans drew parity with a penalty right before Jordan Ayew replicated that feat and also went out there and put Ghana ahead. Randy, people will say, listen, this is a rebuilding phase for the Black Stars. But then again, even in a rebuilding phase, you want to see certain glimpses. Are you seeing those glimpses?
Well, Gosi, I think that we just have to keep it cool as it stands now. No much pressure. Because I have the notion that if you're going to build a team, you need time to build a team. But do we all have that time for Otto Addo and then the Black Stars setup to rebuild this particular team? Because, I mean, people are so eager for this team to win trophies. I am yet to actually see something big from this particular setup. Yeah. There is no much difference, honestly.
Yeah, we've seen a big boot forward from Uganda, but that was a very poor miscontrol from the team.
Lack
the
defense, of communication. What was that?
Definitely. The Ghanaian team's defense seems to be in sixes and sevens at the back, prodding the ball among each other without any trajectory whatsoever. Would the Ugandans take advantage of this? They're taking the ball again. They are piecing a few passes together on the right. Bayo can't advance with it. He wins a throw-in for the Cranes of Uganda, who will look to make further incursions into the box of the Black Stars, looking at the defensive frailties that are being made manifest. On the right side of attack, Bayo once again, the man in the number 7 shirt, what is he going to do? He finds absolutely nobody.
Well, it's quite cagey and dicey. Both teams are putting up their maximum best. Uganda, despite being down, they seem to be enjoying play. I mean, they still maintain their composure, passing the ball, even looking at the threat of Ghana in the past five minutes, they seem to be so much reserved. And I wouldn't be surprised that they can easily come back from behind to pull parity as far as this particular game is concerned.
Definitely.
Ghana should also take advantage of their chances that they create. Because I mentioned earlier that it all has to do with their finishing, the last third of the field. If indeed they would want to add more goals, then they need to be very serious with what they do up front.
Definitely, we look to see what they do up front. We've seen very little of some of the debutants, especially Ebenezer Annan, who's playing at left fullback, yet to fully come into the game. A big boot forward from the Ugandans. Who do they find? They find the head of Edmond Addo, who recycles position for the Black Stars, who find a way to give it away again in the center of the park. Yes, definitely. The Black Stars recover the ball through Annan, who plots forward. He finds Abdul Salih Samed, who has been a pivot in midfield. He's held that position very, very mercurially. He goes to the right. He finds Dennis Odoi. He finds Abdul Fatah Ishaaku, who finds Francis Abu. Francis Abu with the ball back again to Jerome Opoku. Jerome Opoku stands on it, gives another very accurate pass to Francis Opoku. Abdul Salih Samed. Francis Abu. Abdul Salih Samed again. Francis Abu with the ball. Takes it back again. Jerome Opoku. He looks forward. Is he going to go long? Is he going to pass? He finds the easy option of the pass. Otto Addo is wondering, what do I have to do to break down this very resolute Ugandan side? The Cranes, who lost two Comoros in their last game, bear in mind, head-to-head, a long ball forward. Antoine Semenyo is offside. In head-to-head, the last five games they've played, Ghana has won one, Uganda has won one, and three have ended in draws.
So it's actually it's a fair playing ground for both teams.
Definitely.
There is no super house in this particular game. And so it's an open game. Uganda can actually pull some surprises into this game. Ghana as well should be watchful, because it's still early days here. The first 45 minutes seem not ending. I mean, anytime soon, there's still enough time. They tell you that in 5 minutes of football, it's a lot of time for teams to score. You remember our AFCON debacle, where we considered two goals or three goals in just 4 minutes. So it's very possible that anything at all could happen.
Definitely. So on the right side, Bayo, he's looking for Mukwala. Mukwala, a name who do very, very, very popular to Ghanaians, and he manages to foul the Ghanaian defender.
But I'm not too impressed with the back line of the Black Stars.
I think you look at the fact that they've not played together before. Ebenezer Annan and Edmond Addo already are on yellow cards in this game. Jerome Opoku and Dennis Odoi. I mean, this is a very new look back line for the Black Stars. They need to gel, especially since Edmond Addo is not traditionally a defender. Paul Put, the man in charge of the cranes of Uganda, will need a lot of firepower to get his team back. Jordan Ayew drops deep. He finds Ebenezer Annan on the left side of defense. Jordan Ayew, is he going to go long? No. He goes into the middle of the park. He finds Abdul Fattah Ishahaku, who finds Dennis Odoi, the professor. Who is he going to find in the box? He doubles on it. Comes back, finds Abdul Fattah Ishahaku. A nice backflip. Mohamed Abu, oh, the cross is blocked by the cranes of Uganda. Is a throw-in to the Black Stars of Ghana, who will look to consolidate that lead that they've taken going into halftime. 38 minutes played at the Stade Marrakech. It's Uganda 1, Ghana 2. The international friendly game that is yet to fully spark fire. Otto Addo will be looking to ignite that.
So two things for us to look out for. One, the identity the Black Stars will be coming up with, because over the period we've lost it. Are we still going to have the passing type of game?
That's, I mean, Annan is making incursions into the box. He finds Ernest Nyama. Takes on one, takes on two. The shot goes wide. Ernest Nyama was looking for the spectacular. He's a lot of player. He's a player who plays for Lyon in France. Operates on the left wing or on the right wing. In this game, it looks like he's operating in the central position as a number 10. So the Ugandans pass it short from the back. The Ghanaians don't seem to be in the mood to press. The Ugandans go long. It's a big boot forward for Uganda. Who are they going to find? Absolutely nobody. But then again, they maintain possession, fighting spirit against the Ghanaians. They believe that they can get one back. Ghana win the ball through Edmond Addo, who is warming his way into this game. They start all over from the back. With the build-up. Currently, Ghana still wield majority of the possession in this game, coming to you live from the Stade Marrakech inside of Morocco.
So far, so good for the Black Stars. Dominance level has been high. They keep possessing the ball, but like I stated earlier, two things for us to look out for. Getting the identity, passing of the ball, taking full custody of the game as well as one important thing, and also trying to bang in the goals, because we really need goals if we should go forward. Now, I mean, look at this sluggish.
Definitely. Jordan Ayew gives the ball away. I mean, the Ugandans on the counter attack. Who is he going to find? He finds, but he goes left. He finds Badwi. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. The Ugandans can't make the most of a sluggish Black Stars play. The Black Stars recover at the back. Are they going to build again? They win a free kick.
And that was quite feeble. I mean, not many referees would have even given that as a free kick. Why would Jordan lose such a ball around that area? But like I said, if we are going to take full control over this game, if you are going to write an emphatic name, then it should be now. It should be in this particular game. We don't need to miss out on the chances that we create. And we don't let go of the ball, especially when we get to the goal scoring area of the opponent. Else, they will capitalize on any of the sluggish mistakes and punish us for it.
Definitely. Currently, they haven't. They have on one occasion where they won a penalty.
Yeah.
So Mutiaba is looking to close down Edmond Addo. Steven Mukwala got that goal from the spot. So currently, the Black Stars are in possession. They are in possession with Mohamed Abu. Who does he find in the middle? Antoine Semenyo, who has been very, very anonymous in the game. He pushes one forward. Who does he find? He doesn't find anybody but Sibik of Uganda. Uganda starts building up again. A long ball forward, headed in by Jerome Opoku. The ball is ping-pong in the middle of the park. Is that a foul? No, the referee says play on. So the Black Stars are in possession. They give the ball away once again. They seem to be recycling possession, but no. Annan crosses the ball. Will he find Semenyo? He does find Semenyo. Will Semenyo shoot? He dallies on it. Semenyo, is the chance gone? No, Abdul Fattah Ishahaku, trademark. No, absolutely miles off. That ball should have landed on Mars at this point in time.
It's the same story that we have seen over the period. Now, you can even count the number of red shirts in the 18-yard box against the number of white shirts that were actually putting the pressure on this particular defense. It could have been so easy for the white shirts to score if they had taken full advantage of the situation, because they messed up with the ball, they had advantage, and again, Semenyo controlled, never had any solution, never had any decision immediately, and we blew it away.
Definitely. So Ikara behind the ball, is he going to go long? Ikara goes long for the Ugandan Cranes, and he finds his player. The Black Stars win the ball. It's another foul to the Cranes of Uganda as Semakula is brought down. Semakula is brought down. And what can Uganda do with this set piece? The Black Stars are still on top when it comes to statistics of this game. Definitely, in terms of possession, the Black Stars are on top. Head to head, when these teams met on the 7th of October in 2017, ended goalless. 17th January 2017 in the Cup of Nations, Ghana beat Uganda by a lone goal. The last time the Cranes beat Ghana was in 2014 in the African Cup of Nations, where Uganda also beat Ghana by a lone goal. The Black Stars are pinging the ball together at the back. Jerome Opoku on the ball now, a very dominating figure. It's a back pass, and Jojo Walakot finds a way to rescue his team. The man they call the professor plots it on. In the middle of the park, Abdul Fatah Shahaku. Is he going to go long? Yes, he does go long. And he finds Anan. Anan with a fantastic control of the ball. He finds Ernest Nyama in the middle of the park. Ernest Nyama is unable to control it. He seems to be struggling in that number 10 position.
That's a big boot to wear. Looking at the style of play we have and the people that we are playing against, definitely. And like I mentioned earlier, this is actually more or less like a new team Otto Addo is building. So you have debutants coming up, and it's a mixture of the old and then the new players. So definitely the telepathy might seem quite difficult in this particular game. But with time, they can pick up.
One of the old players who is relatively new, Dennis Odoi. The man on the pitch wearing the number 3 shirt definitely has won that foul for Ghana. Joining us in the studio, we have Mr. Samuel Apia, who's watching this game with eagle eyes for us. Samuel,
hi.
How are you doing, sir?
I'm okay. Yourself?
I'm doing very
Randy,
well.
Good Thank afternoon.
You. Yeah, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. The Black Stars are leading by 2-1 against Uganda. A fair reflection of the game for you, Samuel.
Yeah, I think that it's been a very good game. Just like what Randy was saying, I think that we are gradually building an identity. I think one thing I've realized is that these are new players, young players, but they seem to be playing with no fear, but just that they keep giving the balls away, which is not, a trick.
To the Black Stars in attack. There's a shot from Ernest Nyama. That was close. Right over the bar. Ernest Nyama wants to prove a point in this game. He's becoming lively in that number 10 role. He's taking shots. He's testing the defense of the Cranes of Angola. It's 45 minutes played with 1 minute of added time inside the Stade de Marrakech inside Morocco. The Black Stars of Ghana lead the Cranes of Uganda by 2-1. Goals gotten by Jordan Ayew and Jerome Opoku for the Black Stars, and Mukwala for the Cranes of Uganda. Then again, the Black Stars win a free kick towards the tail end of this first half, where the Black Stars, towards the tail end of this first half, where the Black Stars have completely dominated possession. They've had a very, very good game. Semenyo, who has been very highly anonymous, is unable to keep that ball in play, and the Cranes of Uganda would go into halftime trailing against the Black Stars of Ghana in Stade de Marrakech. It's been 45 minutes of not so explosive football. 45 minutes where the Black Stars will be introspecting and saying, listen, we do have a job to do there. The Ugandan Cranes as well are not down. They are not out of this. They'll go into that dressing room believing that they can claim another stake in this game. It's halftime at Stade de Marrakech. It's Uganda 1, Ghana 2.
Come on, come on. Your flight is ready to leave.
Sit back and relax and enjoy the flight.
Sent by God.
I am an angel. An angel from God.
They're angels, just like I wished for.
When you walk down the road, heavy burden, heavy load, I will rise and I will walk with you. When you walk through the night and you feel like you want to just give up on the fight, I will come and I will walk.
Watch your favorite TV show in your pan. TV on the go. Load the WoezorTV app for Android on Play Store or for iOS on the Apple Store. TV made easier. WoezorTV, we go all out for you.
To the live coverage of that friendly game between Ghana and Uganda happening inside Morocco. It's halftime, and the Black Stars have their noses in front. That game is currently at 2-1 in favor of Ghana. We're going to go straight into the analysis, starting off with you, Sammy. Ghana lead 2-1. I mean, looking at the squad, I mean, I'm going to go through it very quickly. The starting lineup, Otto Addo made five changes from the previous game. We had the likes of Jojo Wallacott come in, the likes of Ebenezer, Anan, etc. come in. We saw a whole host of players. But then again, for a lot of Ghanaians, looking across social media, their bone of contention has been, why is Edmond Addo being played at centre-back?
Well, I think that, for me, I think Otto is trying to try something new, honestly, because if you see coaches do these things, they don't do it just for mere sake. I think that he wants to try something. I and you, who are in the sporting circles, really know the real position of Edmond Addo, but this time around, we see him playing around playing centre-back, which is an unfamiliar position for him. But I think that as a coach, Otuadi, he's trying to build a new team. He's trying to introduce some new positions or new style of play. And this is a very young team. And so for me, I think that he's trying to put players into places where, I mean, you can call on them at any point in time. And so for me, it's a bit surprising. But I think, I mean, if we're a coach and you really want to build a very solid team, these are some of the things that you need to do. You need to vary your tactics. You need to put in players that you can trust, and you know that when I put them there, they can do the job for me. I mean, it reminds me of Victor Moses, and when Antonio Conte came to Chelsea, he was a proper attacker. But I mean, Antonio Conte came to Chelsea and realized that, listen, he's a player that I think that I can use him at the wing back, and he used Victor Moses at that position, and he flourished, and he was scoring goals for fun. And at the end of the day, Chelsea won the Premier League. these are the things that I think a good coach always will want to try. And I think that by he doing that, I'm tempted to believe that he's doing that on a positive note. And let's all wait and see the result that will come out from that.
Let's all wait and see. A very good evening to David Soa Atriki and his squad who are watching us live. Definitely. Randy.
Yeah, question.
Uganda themselves will come into this game having a lot to recover, considering the fact that they lost by 4-0 to Comoros in a friendly before this. They are trailing again. Paul Put, very good manager. I mean, what will he be telling us his charges?
Well, of course, this is a good exercise for both teams, and that's why it's called a friendly, just to augment the loopholes, just to correct the few mishaps the team would have going forward as far as the other tournaments or proper competitions are concerned. Uganda, yes, definitely, they lost their first game, I mean, as far as the friendly is concerned. Ghana, on the other side, also lost their game against Nigeria a few days ago. So it's a game of equal strength. And riding on the head-to-head that these two teams have, I mean, it's obvious that it's going to be quite tough. It's going to be a tough game for these two sides. Mind you, Ghana, or the Black Stars, would want to write a good name, knowing so well that they have fallen out of favor and love from the fans back here in Ghana and across the world. They would want to make make amends as far as the game is concerned. And also bearing in mind that just few days ago, you've had the under 20 side, the male side, win the African Games. You've had the female team also win.
Ironically, they beat Uganda.
Uganda, exactly. So more or less, like, there's going to be a repeat.
Uganda and Nigeria.
Exactly the point. So the first game, it was against Nigeria. We beat Nigeria in the finals, and then Uganda as well. So it's going to be either a revenge or a repeat in today's game. But I mean, Uganda, they aren't performing badly at all. They would have to create more chances, and they would have to capitalize on the chances. Ghana seem to be enjoying the possession as it stands, but the question is that, can you translate the possession into getting goals as far as the game is concerned? Because at the end of the day, what the fans want to see is that, yes, indeed, the identity will count, but of course, you should be able to get more goals, and that is what the fans would want to see. But would it be easy when we keep making petty mistakes at the last third of the field? I mean, Jordan, with all his experience, should be one of the players to carry the team on when the other experienced players are absent. And I'm yet in the first 45 minutes.
So he's actually captaining the
team. Yes, exactly. In the first 45 minutes.
He converted a penalty.
Come on, Koshi. I mean, the Ugandans also converted a penalty. And I am saying that, look, we need somebody who can just carry the team. Jordan, with his experience, his exposure, should be one man who should be recognized as the talisman in today's game. He should carry the team on his shoulders. And so far, I've not seen that with him in this game.
He hasn't seen that with Jordan. But then again, the likes of Abdul Fattah Ishaku and the likes of Ernest Nyama are seen as the future of this team. Nyama is being played in a number 10 role. Fattah Ishaku has been anonymous at the right side. I mean, is it a matter of tactics, or is the fact that they are still warming up into this new setup being brewed by Otuadu?
Well, I think gradually Otuadu is trying to test, I mean, something new with this boy. But I think that these boys, you see them playing in those positions, I think that that is their natural position. And I think that for me, Ernest Nyama under 23, we saw him play similar position, more trying to join the attackers and all that. We've seen Fattah Ishaku at Leicester City in the English Championship. And I think that these two players you talk about, then I think that Otuado, I'm tempted to believe that he's playing them in their rightful position. Remind you, I mean, Ishaku at Stafford FC before he moved to Dreams FC, before going to Europe to Sporting, and now finds himself at Leicester City. And I think that that is his rightful position for in his Nyama. We know how explosive he can be. And you remember, even if you recall the game against Nigeria, he played him as a false nine, even though he didn't pay off. But now he's playing at the number 10 role, also trying to join the attackers. And I think that these are young players with so much pace and with that gift of being explosive. I mean, and so for me, I think that for Ernest Nyama, I think that in my 10 role, for me, I think he being young, and if we are saying that we are building a new team, I'm tempted to believe that Otuado would want to do something magnificent with him.
Now let's look at the players on the bench, Randy. On the bench, we've got Lawrence Atizigi, Frederick Asari, Alidu Seydou, Kasim Nuhu, Mohamed Salisu, Tariq Lamte, Patrick Pozo, Abdullah Nuruddin, Andre Dede Ayu, Baba Idrisu, and Ibrahim Osman. Now, people have pointed out that looking at the bench, there isn't any real firepower there isn't that striker who you feel can come on and make a difference. There's a host of midfielders and defenders, etc. Is it a lack of talent in that department for the
Blackstars? No, not at all. I think that we can't lack when it comes to the striking force. You remember, I think Inaki was part of the collab, but eventually pulled out because he asked for time. Fully on club football as well. I'm not saying he's the only striker that we have. There is Antoine Semenyo in the setup as well, but there are a couple of other players. Now, the names you have mentioned that are part of the reserve players on the bench, I mean, we've seen them. We've seen them over and over again. They've played for the Black Stars over time, and we know what they are capable of doing. So it's just best, and I feel that, yes, indeed, Otto got it right by giving the opportunity to some of the deputants to star in the game for us to actually see what they can also give out as far as this game is concerned.
I mean, talking of that, I think yesterday when he was with CEO, he spoke to the GFA media ahead of this game, and he was clear that he was going to give the young players.
Of course. So,
I mean, because he said, I mean, the phrase that he used was that this is a chance for them. Yeah. We need to test them. We need to integrate them proper. Because I knew, we'll come to that conclusion that if Kudus is fit, if Inaki is fit, if Andre, for me, you guys know my stand on Andre, but Kudus, Inaki, and the key players, Partey, if these guys are fit, I'm not sure that Annan or these guys will slot straight into the team.
I mean, what the likes of Mohamed Abu, etc. Yeah, I mean, what have you made of them?
Yeah, I think that they've been great, honestly. I think that they've been okay, honestly.
The game is telling it all because we are dominating. That is
exactly,
one.
Yeah, sure.
We are in the lead as far as the game. Yeah. The scoreline is also concerned. Yeah. So far, so good with the Black Stars, but expectations are high.
Uganda losing 4-0 to Comoros.
Yes, and
it's
going to
be
huge. But we are playing against Uganda.
Yeah.
We played against Nigeria, which happens to be a superhouse.
Exactly.
So one will make an argument that you are playing against Uganda.
But Uganda, I mean, looking at the head-to-head, we've played in the last five games, there's been three draws, one win for Uganda and one win for Ghana.
So it's almost like, that's why I stated in my earlier remarks, I mentioned that this is actually a game of equals.
Exactly.
No one is above the other. It's a game of equals if you want to base it on the head-to-head. There is one particular player I would want to see in the second half. It has to do with Pozo.
The left back.
Yeah, exactly. I would really want to see him.
Anand is on a yellow card, so there's a high possibility he would come.
Because this is the second game that after this game, the players would have to go on back to their clubs. Sure.
And they'll come back in June for the World Cup qualifiers.
For a qualifier. And a qualifier, we can't gamble. Yeah. That's the word. We can't gamble. We can't take chances just like that. So it is good we try the players that we have now. Otto needs to get his core membership as far as the starting 11 of the Black Stars is concerned. These two games is enough for him because he's been with the team quite recently. I mean, he left not too long ago, so he still has a core of the team. If he keeps them, he's just going to add up to the team that he already has. And I feel that it should be the best way. I'm looking up to see Pozo star in this particular game.
Definitely. Pozo at left back, he's had a lot of experience playing in the Champions League, etc. He's played against the likes of Real Madrid. So a lot of people are looking forward to seeing Patrick Pozo. I don't know if he's a solution to Ghana's left-back problems. But then again, we would live to see that. Now,
For the right side, I think that he's sorted. Because if you have someone like Tariq Lamptey, who is young and energetic, I mean, you know that that place is sorted. But for the left-back, I think that I side with you on that same question. We are yet to see, though.
Francis Abu, another one who a lot of people have touted as one of the next big things for Ghana. Looking at the profile of player he is and the fact that he's complementing a certain Abdul Salih Tamez, Samed, he's not just another of those shadow midfielders who we've seen playing as sixes.
Well, I don't think so. And honestly, it's very surprising for the boldness of Otto Addo to include such players, because these are players that you really don't hear much of them, and so they come into this side. What are they coming to do? But I think that so far, I think that he's not been bad. Honestly, I don't think he's been bad. I think he's been okay, because I'm tempted to believe that this is his first game for the Black Stars and against Uganda. Yeah, they are not a bigger opposition like compared to the Nigeria, but I think so far he's been good, and I think that with time, these players that Otto Addo has called, these debutants, these young players, most of them, Randy was talking about, he's seen Pozo. I wouldn't be surprised. I would be a bit excited to see even Frederick Asari come. Mm-hmm. I mean replace Jojo Waloko, because I mean Mukwala scored, who plays for Asantikotoko, and now he's scoring against a Black Stars team. I think that Frederick Asari too will be proud of himself to even make his debut. So these are some of the things. But for Abu, I believe that I think he'll come good, and with time I think that we're really going to see exactly what he's made of.
Definitely Mukwala scores for the Ugandans, Ghanaian fans, Kotoko fans.
Yeah, Kotoko fans.
We'll be seeing. I mean, come on. So a fun fact, Jordan Ayew has scored 4 goals in his last 3 games for the Black Stars, and guess what? They've all come from the penalty spot. So Jordan Ayew is a penalty merchant, they call him. So we're getting ready to move into the second half. At start, the Marrakesh, watching us live again, is Mr. David Atriki and Rexford. Good evening to you. Inside the Lene building, good evening to you. Thank you for joining us. Of all of you that have joined us both online and on screen, thank you for joining us on WoezorTV, where we make sure we go all out for you. The players are coming onto the pitch. I'm sure we'll see a raft of changes. We'll take you through all of those changes as and when they are made. While we anticipate the second half of this crunch friendly between the Black Stars of Ghana and the Cranes of Uganda. Randy, any expectations for our second half?
Well, I think that yes, we should create more chances, take full advantage of the chances, because if we are not careful, the Ugandans can easily punish us. I mentioned the fact that our defense seemed not to be so much agile. Few mistakes they have put up so far, and if you're not careful, the Ugandans will capitalize on that and punish us for it. So it is time, if indeed we want to write an emphatic name moving forward, it is time we need to increase our tally as far as the goals are concerned.
Sami, second half, what should we expect?
Well, I'm expecting that, listen, these guys will keep on playing with the same tempo that we're playing. They should play with no fear. They should know that this Ugandan side cannot be compared to the Nigerian side that they played against on Friday. I think that they should take their chances, and I think that they shouldn't leave space out. I think that they should try as much as possible to create more spaces and openings and try to bury the goals as well.
Definitely. So the Black Stars kick off the second half at the start. The Marrakesh inside Morocco, where they have their noses in front. 2-1 against the Cranes of Uganda. The Black Stars on the ball at the back once again. Mohamed Abuku has been a very impressive. Edmond Adwa, the center of defense, gives that ball straight. It's a very, very long boot for it, targeting the man they call the professor. But the professor can profess that was too long for him to access. So it's a throw-in to the Cranes of Morocco, who would look to at least come back and show the Black Stars that there are no walkovers whatsoever. The ball is being pinged in and out with Jordan Ayew, and it's Antoine Semenyo has been very anonymous. The man who plays for Bournemouth in the English Premier League has been anonymous, and that surely should be a foul. No, the referee says play on as the ball goes all the way back to Joseph Jojo Walacott, who in turn finds Edmond Adewu, recycles the ball and gives it back to Mohamed Abu, who as well finds at the center of defense Jerome Opoku. Jerome Opoku is looking for his options. What's he going to do? He goes back short to Edmond Adu, who is somewhat playing as a liberal at the back of that defense. He finds Abu once again. He looks for a very long ball. No, he doesn't go long. He finds Jerome Opoku, who goes long, looking for Antoine Semenyo. No, he doesn't find him. It was, in fact, Abdul Fattah Shahaku who pursued that ball, but he relentlessly pursued it to no avail, and Uganda will have the chance to play out from the back in what has started as a very, very lively second half, Randy.
Well, so early days yet into the second half, and expectations are high, as I mentioned earlier, but we should. I feel that the pace of the game has gone so low. I don't know if it's a tactical way from Otto, but I feel we should see more of the runs from the players. If indeed we should score, we should force the defense or their defense out. They should come forward so we can capitalize on that and score. But if we keep the game so slow, it's going to be quite difficult for us to get more goals.
Definitely. So the Ugandans have made a few substitutions. Out came Sibic and Mutiaba, and in came Lualiwa and AK Watamba. They made way. So the Ghana team remains exactly as it is, with Jojo Walacott in goal, Anan Opoku and Edmond Adu and Odoi make up the back four. Abdul Salih Samed and Abu Francis are holding the midfield. And Ernest Nyama plays in that number 10 role. Jordan Ayew on the left, Abdul Fattah Shahaku on the right, and Antoine Semenyo has been tasked to lead the line and find those goals for the Black Stars, two of which they have found already through the boot of Jordan Ayew and the head of Jerome Opoku. Otto Addo is inquiring, why are you not moving the ball as fast as you are? It's a very physical game. The Black Stars absolutely need to keep a cool head. The Ugandans are not lying down. They are showing true resilience here, fighting for every 50-50 ball. It's getting very physical. What can the Ugandan Cranes do? And Mukwala up front, what can he do? No, Edmond Addo proves too strong for Mukwala, who ends up conceding a free kick against Edmond Addo. Sammy,
yeah.
I mean, the second half has started in a very cagey manner.
Yeah.
Who do you think is looking even more prospectively to get the next goal?
I mean, look at how the Ugandans have started. It tells you that. I mean, look at how they are pressing. Look at how they are forcing Ghana to play the ball at their own,
yeah.
I mean, half. And so it tells you that they are really, really, I mean, they are really serious to get a goal, because this summer I think that they are trying to correct their mistake that they committed in the first half, and I think that if they're able to get an early goal in the second half, then I think that it will unsettle Ghana. I think that it will be a game that, I mean, getting a winner now become very, 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 I mean, difficult for both sides. But I think that the Ugandans have really started very, very well.
Antoine Semenyo with that one, but then again, he only finds the side netting. Antoine Semenyo, like I said, has been very, very anonymous in this game. And again, we did expect that he at least will find the back of the net against the Ugandans to stretch the lead for the Black Stars. The Ugandans are currently on the back foot, backpedaling. It is a break in play. There's an injury to the Ugandan player. So the Ugandan player, Bumono, is on the pitch, currently receiving treatment from the physios. That seemed to be a very, very difficult one for him to take. But Antoine Semenyo should have done better than again to find the net for the Black Stars of Ghana, who look to find their rhythm. On the bench, and that could come on, we have Lawrence Atizigi, Alidu Seydou, Kasim Nuhu, Mohamed Salisu, who only recently joined the team, Forcing Andre Ayew, Osman Bukhari, Tariq Lamptey, Patrick Pozo, Nuhu Abdullahi, Idrisu Baba, Osman, and Asare, who is the goalkeeper, and they are under the tutelage of none other than Otto Addo, who's a second coming, started with a defeat.
It was well expected, honestly. I think that you are going to play against the 2023 African Cup of Nations runners up with that quality, and look at how they performed so well, incredibly. But in the case of Ghana, I think that it was another disaster, and so it was well expected, even though. I mean, one surprising thing is that most of their key players didn't even feature. You can talk about Osimhen, he being the key man for the side, and still we learn. So for me, I think that it was well expected.
Well expected. So almost 52 minutes played inside the Stade de Marrakech, inside Morocco, and the Black Stars are currently leading the Ugandan Cranes by 2-1 in a game that is heating up by the minute. The ball is being won in midfield. Abdul Salih Samed, who has very, very simply controlled that midfield. He's been the metronome of the team. He's kept the team ticking. It goes long, looking for Antoine Semenyo. They don't find Antoine Semenyo, who is then again looking very isolated up front. The Black Stars will look to keep the ball in play. But it's a throw-in to the Black Stars of Ghana, and this throw-in will be effected by Dennis Odoi, who has very well marshalled the right side of the Black Stars defense. So Jerome Opoku, he finds Anan storms forward, and who does he find? He finds Abdul Salih Samed. Is he going to go for it? Yes, he does. He finds Abu finds Ernest Nwama is forward. No, he's not. The referee says play on. That was neatly won. The Ugandans are on the counter attack. No, they give the ball away. Absolutely, they cannot ping two or three passes together. The Black Stars recover after giving the ball away. It is looking very fiercely as we do go along. On the left, Anan goes all the way back, finds his defensive partner in Jerome. Jerome moves forward. Who does Jerome find? Abdul Salih Samed once again. Edmond Adu and Mohamed Abu on the ball. He looks forward. Is he going to go? Yes, he goes for a pass. Finds Antoine Semenyo looking at space. He goes back again. The Black Stars are being very measured in their build-up, looking to break down this very intricate Ugandan side. And the ball goes forward to the left. Anan takes on his man. He goes back again. Does he lose the ball? Yes, he does. He loses the ball to the Ugandans. What can they do? Do they have enough men forward? They are streaming forward. They keep the ball. He goes back. Yes. So Buono with the ball all the way back. And the Ugandans have recovered possession. And then again, Buono with that ball to Mugabe. And Mugabe to Mutiaba. Samankula goes all the way to the right. He's looking for Matu. And Matu takes on his man. He beats him. He beats him once again. Inside out. Is he going to cross? Matu, is he going to cross? Is he going to cross? He holds on to the ball too long and walks it out of play. And the Ugandans do not make the most of a rare chance that came their way, Randy.
And that's how dangerous they will get along the line. And that's why I said that let's introduce some new players. Let's see what they can also bring on board. We've already seen what the first 45 minutes can give as far as this game is concerned. Ugandans will always want to come hard. The head-to-head is a big, emphatic writing for them, which they would want to capitalize on. So if you are not careful, if the Black Stars are not so careful, they are going to cry in this particular game.
Yes, so the Black Stars are not careful. The Ugandans will give them a shock of their life. Antoine Semenyo, he currently looks shell-shocked because he feels that he won that. Like I said, he has been very anonymous. The Ugandans have the ball. They are having a much better second half than they finished the first half in Marrakech inside Morocco, where the Black Stars are taking on the Moroccans. Mugabe on the ball. He goes along trying to find Mukwala. No, he doesn't. The player goes down on the pitch. If I'm right, that is Lualiwa. Lualiwa goes down on the pitch. Let's see, he deserves some treatment. Would Otuado take this opportunity to give his players a pep talk? Sami,
yeah.
I mean, a lot of people have said, listen, Otuado is still trying to weave his way with regards to tactics. But looking at the material that he has, do you feel he's making the most of them in games like these?
Oh yeah, exactly. Especially the Nigerian game. I think in the second half, I was so much impressed until, I mean, Nigeria increased their tally, because I think even with 10 men, I think that Ghana really, really played very well. And so, just like I said, these are players that are now making their debut. I mean, they're making their debut at the Black Stars. Some of them are not even coming close their first time. And now they are playing against Nigeria. Even you look at the goals that they conceded against Nigeria, it's all about petty mistakes. But I think that if you have these young players, these young lads, and they are playing like this, it tells you that when you have your full complement of the team, when your key players are back, the likes of Kudus, the likes of Partey, the likes of Inaki Williams, where you can really, really implement your full, I mean, style and rhythm and how you want to play, I think that there seem to be a bit of future for this team. But these young players now making their debut and they are playing at this, I mean, level, I think massive credit to Otuado.
Massive credit to Otuado for blooding these youngsters in and making sure that at least we have a semblance of a future for the Ghana national team. The Ugandans, then again, would not care too much about the future. All they care about is now and getting that equalizer against the Black Stars of Ghana, and they look to be fighting for the ball. Bayo, he finds Mukwala. What can he do? He takes on his player, he crosses the ball in, and oh my god, the Black Stars clear that with aplomb. Would the Moroccans, would the Ugandans come again? Yes, they do. It's wave after wave of attack. The defense seems to be under a lot of pressure, but then called upon. The defense made up of Jerome Opoku and Edmond Adu score full marks, and Jojo Walakot very comfortably holds that ball, gives it to Mohamed Abu. What is he going to do? He goes back to Edmond Adu, who has been a stalwart in that defense. He's been, like I said, that liberal. You know, back in the day, we had this position we called the liberal, the last man behind the center backs who recycled play. Yes, so he has played as a liberal. Remember the likes of Sam Johnson, who were very good at playing every position at the back, including as a liberal. And Edmond Adu is doing exactly that. Intricate midfield play. Ernest Nuamah with the ball. Are we going to see some twinkle little feet from him? No, he keeps it very simple and goes back to Edmond Adu, who seems to have the most touches in this game. Everything is going through him.
Yes, it's because of the possession that he. I think that if Ghana loses possession, he's the one to restart. I mean, in terms of progressing the ball, he's the one to start everything. And so, I mean, you shouldn't be surprised. The position that he's playing is very, very surprising. But then I think that he's been so wonderful. I think he's been so key to this side. I think going forward, these are some of the players. He has not been good under. I mean, Chris. He was not good under Chris Hughton, but I think that Otuadu think that listen, this is a player that I think that if he, I mean, he can fit into my philosophy, and so we shouldn't be surprised with how he's playing.
So the Black Stars will need to conspire with each other and give the ball away once again to the Ugandans, who struggle to keep it in. Then again, they need to keep themselves in this game, and they'll be looking at their bench that has the likes of Dennis Omedi, Aliro Okabo, Mohamed Shaban, Mujaguzi, Opondo, and Asimwe, and Mugume to come and rescue them from the clutches of the Black Stars. They are making incursions for it. A nice pass. It goes to the right to Mato. Mato is unable to do anything with it. The ball comes back again to Samankula. Samankula is looking for Bayo. That's a shot. Is that going to be a rebound? Oh, no. Oh, no. It's a corner kick to the Ugandans. The Cranes definitely are plowing their way through the Black Stars.
I think the Ugandans have really, really started well. There is one positive thing that you can take from the Black Stars, that even if they are under pressure, they can still contain the pressure. But if you meet a clinical opposition, regardless, they are going to force you to make the mistakes.
Just watch. I mean, where the ball keeps coming from. It's always been from the left side. Most of the crosses are coming from the left
and
side.
And that left side,
it's getting quite weak.
So that left side
should be watched carefully.
Steven Mukwala is playing on that left side. He keeps rotating with Matu. They are controlling the game. So it's a corner. It's going to be an in-swinger from the side of the Ugandans. That's a long one in. A header. Oh my God! The Ugandans were whiskers away from equalizing against the Black Stars. The defense were caught napping in sixes and sevens. They were asleep as that flick on nearly crept in to the near post. But the Black Stars will be thanking their stars that this didn't go in. Jojo Walakot gives the ball to Edmond Adu. Abu looks to progress it. He looks to be that one who take it forward. He does, but no, he doesn't progress. He gives the ball away to the Ugandans, and he wins a free kick.
I think
in that regard,
it was a clear foul.
I am yet to even see something great from the strikers, both strikers. I mean, from the two teams. I mean, some sort of shot on target, keep the keeper on toes or something. I'm yet to see that really.
But we just saw that amazing piece of play from Steven Mukwala.
From the Ugandans, yes, that's quite interesting.
I mean,
to see
Mukwala has been lively. I mean, he's been lively for the Ugandan national team. I mean, how Ghana would do with a striker who's that lively. Antoine Semenyo has been very, very, very quiet. But then again, the Ugandans have showed but that they have what it takes to come into this game, by the agility of Jojo Walakot. So that is a long boot forward, looking for nobody in particular. Oh, but he finds Abdul Fattah Ishaku. Does he take on his man? He does, but no. That runs out of play. Abdul Fattah Ishaku has been a pedestrian in this game so far, playing on the right side of the Ghana attack. That has yet to come to life. Then again, we can see a few changes being readied. We can see the likes of Mohamed Salisu. We can see the likes of Tariq Lamte, etc. Would they make a difference? The Black Stars said they certainly need a new injection of energy as the Ugandans come forward and try their best. But then again, that is a very hopeless ball forward, and the Black Stars pick up possession again through Jerome Opoku, who takes his time, stands on the ball, tries to spread his antenna wide and scan. Then again, Mohamed Abu, who's playing as a deep line playmaker, picks up the ball, finds Ernest Abdul Fattah Ishaku. He takes it all the way to the left. That's a fantastic pass to the man they call the professor. What can he do? Absolutely nothing. The ball rolls out Jordan Ayew. The ball rolls out for Jordan Ayew. Has been anonymous as well. We've not seen much of him in this game.
I mean, obviously, right from the beginning of the game till now, he's been quite quiet on the field of play. Nothing has been felt from Jordan over the period. But I think it is right time for Otto to bring in the new players.
So Ishaku on the left side, right side of attack. He nutmegs his opponent and he's unable to go past the second one. And so that is a corner for the Black Stars.
But definitely. He can still pass. Yeah. He has options.
Yeah, he should have squared the ball.
Yes.
Yeah. So it's time for those changes from Otto Addo. A lot of them seem to be defensive changes. Is he happy with his attack? That has seemed a bit blunt.
Because I'm thinking he just wants to be cautious not to concede again.
Yeah, because the Ugandans look more poised in scoring than us. Because we are not even threatening the goal mouth of the Ugandans. But they look more threatening when they are attacking us. They are always coming from the left side of play. And that area needs to be looked at critically in this game.
So the corner is about to be swung by Ernest Norma. The man from Lyon swings it in. It's a header. Who's going to get to it? Is it going to be Semenyo? Is he going to shoot? Antoine Semenyo passes the ball. And oh, that is into a melee of players by Edmond Addo. And the Ugandans managed to clear. But then again, the Black Stars will look to recycle this. That was indeed a good chance. Amidst all of the chaos in the box of the Ugandans, the Black Stars were unable to take advantage. And they have to come and start from square one again, trying to build up to create more chances. Is a long big boot forward. Who is he looking for? He does find Ernest Nyama, who's moved to the right side, and he is offside. This probably would give Otuado an opportunity to make those changes.
Exactly. I think that is the reason it was a clear offside. I think that is the reason why Ishaku didn't make the move, because you look at the position of Nuama, clearly he was offside. But look at the substitution, just like what you made mention. I think most of them more of like a defensive setup substitution, because you see Terry coming in, you see Ali Dusidi coming in, you see Salisu coming in, and I think the other player in front of Salisu, I'm yet to get to see that player. But I think that, I mean, massive credit to this young player.
That's Forsen.
Forsen Amankwa. Yeah, he came in. I think that we saw a bit of him against Nigeria, and this is another opportunity for him to prove himself to other that really he can really play the Black Stars, even though he's young. But when given the team, I think that, or when given the opportunity, he will play.
Definitely. So those are the changes that you have seen right there. The likes of Tariq Lamte, who plays his football for Brighton in the English Premier League. Mohamed Salisu, who plays his football for Monaco in the French League. He has come on. Forsen Amankwa and Alidu Seydou. They are the players that have come on for the Black Stars. Play has, however, been stopped as the Ugandan player is on the turf. Randy, what difference do you think these changes will make?
Well, so we complain about the back line for the Black Stars, and I think that's where Coach Otuado has decided to augment the loopholes. And I agree with this particular substitution. Indeed, they will inject some sort of freshness into the team as well, because the entire team looks quite. I feel that most of them are quite tired, and bringing new legs, fresh legs, will bring some sort of recuperation into the setup as well. I am so worried about the left side of play as well, because that's where the Ugandans seem to be penetrating or using more of the game. So if much attention is placed on that area, that would be much better for us as well. Now it has to do again with how we finish, because in the second half, in the last 10 or 15 minutes that we have played, we are yet to even push one particular shot on target. We are yet to make any proper.
There hasn't been any yesterday.
There's nothing at all. But the Ugandans have rather showed to us that they can easily score as well. So it's something to look out for.
Something positive from the back line, from Jerome Opoku. I think that you look at the long balls, and I think Inaki, anytime that we have Inaki playing, we keep on saying that we don't supply him with the long balls and all these things. So imagine if Inaki should have been in this setup, I think the long balls really would have helped. And so, I mean, these are some of the things that I think that Otuado will be, I mean, keeping an eye on, because we know that for Inaki, you just have to loop the ball over, I mean, to him, just have to give him the pass and you run and then pick up the ball. And so, I mean, very, very good. But I think that with these young players coming in, Alidu Forsen and the lights coming on, I think that let's also wait and see what, I mean, they will offer. But at the moment, Uganda really, really look dangerous.
Well, Uganda look Dangerous Paul Putz will be scratching his head and wondering that what do I need to do to win a football game. Against Comoros, he was completely walloped. Then again, another yellow card is being flashed by the referee. Who is it going to go to? The Black Stars already are on two yellow cards. Two of the defenders are on yellow cards already. Another yellow card is being flashed. The game is getting very fierce, isn't
exactly,
it?
Yeah. I mean, this should be a friendly, but I think that none of this side are really, really taking it so cool. But
when you have two teams that have, I mean, they are at par, definitely you should expect more of the,
but no, but I'm referring to I'm surprised that, I mean, Comoros defeated
Uganda
by that goal margin, and we are struggling, you know. So it tells you that, mm-hmm. I mean, even though we are building, we need to be patient, we need to have time for Utuado and all this, but I think,
and that's what the problem is. Yeah. Are we ready to have patience for Utuado?
I think that if you don't, I mean, give a coach a 3-year contract with an option of two years, and you wouldn't have patience. I think that you need to have, and that's why, I mean, you awarded him with that long-term contract. And so regardless, you need to have patience. These young players that are coming on, these young players that are now making their debut, are very, very players with future. You can clearly see that. And so for me, I think that you need to have patience, you need to have time, you need to give Utuado time, and I think that with time, I mean, you're going to see the benefits.
Now that's the issue. The time. I mean, giving him time is the main issue.
Because I'm just imagining Ghana failing to qualify for World Cup in America. I mean, just going to look at the regions.
Randy has bad spots.
Yeah, you know, the regions, the rantings, the ranting, and the reaction on social media. It's going to be crazy.
No, but we will see more of the reactions after this game.
Yeah, exactly.
Mind you, that the game against Nigeria was overshadowed by the fact that the Black Princesses took their shine. And not just after this game, people will talk about
definitely.
It.
If you want to see all the reactions to this game, please join us this evening on the Arena, right here on WoezorTV at 7 p.m. sharp. For all of you that are on the broadcast at 7 p.m., we will be going into all the actions and the reactions on the Arena. So please stay tuned. We will be very intricate in our scintillating and pulsating analysis. So the Black Stars are kicking the game off currently at the moment, pinging it across the back. Alidu Seydou with what is his first touch of the game. The man who plays for Stade Rennes in France, he runs into the Ugandan player, and that one goes out for a throw into the Black Stars. Who is he looking to find? Is a long one forward, and he finds Abdul Fatah Ishahaku, who does brilliantly to control the ball. He goes up front, finds Semenyo. Semenyo, what can he do? He looks, he finds Ali Duseidu, Tariq Lamptey. Semenyo, he goes up and finds Abdul Fatah Ishahaku. He should know. He's very measured in their approach. Then again, the ball goes. The Black Stars are putting some great passes together. Can Tariq Lamptey take his man on? He does. He goes back and forth. Can he push across in? He does put across in. Semenyo, that's too high for him. There's nobody to rebound, and the Black Stars managed to recover. That was absolutely brilliant. Yeah. Jojo Walakot comes back, measures it, and the Black Stars cushion themselves and recycle possession.
Yeah.
60-70 minutes played in Stade de Marrakech. The Black Stars of Ghana still lead the Cranes of Uganda by 2-1, and that was good play from Forsan Amankwa, who gets brought down in.
Can we see somebody replace Semenyo?
Well, I mean, you look on the bench and you don't see who's going to come. Is it going to be Usman Bukari? There's no out and out striker on the bench, unless of course you put Jordan forward, and Jordan has been pretty anonymous. You can see how he's giving the ball away. Unless of course you bring on Andre Ayew and play him as a complete number 9, the options seem very limited. The Black Stars seem very comfortable as it stands. It's 2-1. They are completely bossing the statistics without doing anything utterly significant. Something.
Yeah, I think that the only positive thing that you can talk about at the moment is that brilliant cross from Tariq Lamptey. I think that was a very, very good one. So it was unfortunate that the ball couldn't locate anybody in that 80-yard box. But I think that gradually you see the substitution that Utuado making, and you could clearly see that it's having an impact on the game. But I think still we just have to tread cautiously and try as much as possible that any chance that we create, we try to, I mean, score from that chance.
The Ugandans are going for it. The ball goes in. Mukwala is unable to reach it. The Black Stars clear. Tariq Lamptey on the right has been bright since he came on. Abdul Fatah Ishahaku goes down. and wins a free kick for the Black Stars, which would help them to at least calm things down and reduce the tempo a little bit against the Cranes of Uganda. It's still 2-1 to the Black Stars of Ghana, and we're looking to ensure that this game, that it doesn't just peter out, but that the excitement does continue. Jerome Opoku currently on the ball. He looks into the middle of the park and he finds Abdul Salih Samed, who has quietly gone about doing his job. Tariq Lamptey, Ali Dusebu. It looks like Ali Dusebu is playing in a back three.
Yeah,
he's
sure.
playing at the right side of a back three. So Otto Addo has varied his tactics to
try using like more of the wings.
A 3-4-1-2, a 3-4-1-2 formation. With Tariq Lamptey playing at wing back. But then the Ugandans come forward. Are they going to be able to score? No, Jojo Walakot denies them with his feet. That was a very dangerous ball. The Ugandans are finding incursions. They are finding ways to breach this Black Stars defense. Jojo Walakot stands in their way this time. But then again, unlike the Black Stars, I mean, they are creating chances.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what I like I said, I think Ghana should tread cautiously, because it looks like right from the start of the second half, the Ugandans have been purposeful. They are trying to work their way out to get the ball at the back of, I mean, Ghana's net. And I think that is what they have done all this time. Well, I mean, for the past, I think, 20, 25 minutes, I think that is what they've done. And I think massive credit to them. That was a very glorious chance. But I think credit also to, I mean, Jojo Walakot for saving the situation.
Definitely. So we have a few messages as well from all the people watching. Greetings, Randy. Edem Tasson at Tasson Wood Designers, listening live inside the Oxygen City. Ho, they call it the Oxygen City. Wonder why they call it the Oxygen City.
It's the cleanest.
Antoine Semenyo's hometown. Ho. Yes, Antoine Semenyo comes from Ho. You didn't know that.
Are you for real?
Yes. Definitely. So Tariq Lamptey, who is probably from Labadi, it's on the ball right now. Tariq Lamptey, who's from Labadi, is on the ball right now. I mean, we could go to where these guys are from. Abdul Salih Samed, I mean, a pure Tamale boy, is on the ball. There was a time where people said, listen, we didn't have a lot of number nines in the Black Stars. But currently, that is changing. Jerome Opoku definitely finds nobody in the middle. The Ugandans, whether they are from Kampala or wherever, are kindly giving the Black Stars a run for their money. The Black Stars are lucky to have their noses up from that Jordan Ayew penalty during the dying embers of the first half. But currently, the Ugandans seem to be the most likely to go out there, throw goals in, looking for Mukwala. Mukwala, he's brought down. He is brought down. And
I think we have about 15 minutes more to end the entire game. Ghana should be very careful, because history will tell us, in the last games we have played, in the last three games we have played, even at the AFCON, we conceded late in the game. I mean, sometime 4 minutes to end of the game,
2 minutes.
Sometimes 2 minutes to end of the game, and we conceded and we eventually pulled out of the tournament. So I think 15 minutes is still enough. If the players are going to get things right, they need to get it right from now until the end.
I mean,
the composure that they would have to maintain going until the end of the 90 minutes is very important and critical.
A lot of messages on social media are saying the Black Stars should be streets ahead of the Ugandans now. It shouldn't be a 2-1 score.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what I said. Because
so it's an in-swinger from the Ugandans finding nobody. But then again, the Black Stars managed to concede a throw-in to the Cranes of Uganda, who are hauling and trying their best. Yes, and he loses the ball to Antoine Semenyo. Semenyo wins the ball. He's one against two. Yes, he goes out there. He finds Ernest Nyama. What is Ernest Nyama going to do? He takes on his man. Is he going to score? Absolutely.
That was a delicious pass. But I mean, Shahako was not purple.
I mean, Abdul Fattah Shahako, pardon me.
See,
Abdul Fattah, he's been very wasteful. His end product hasn't been
good. Because that was a very, very good chance.
We already know that we have too many dribblers in the team. That was a good pass. You still have the option of giving the back pass, I mean, bringing the pass back to these two people who were already running towards the goal. Why did you decide to dribble again to place the ball?
There's a cross coming in. Can the Black Stars double their tally? The Ugandans clear their lines. They do that very purposefully and very easily. But no, then again, the Black Stars wanted to give the ball away. It's a counter-attack for the Cranes of Uganda, but they're unable to roll that across, and the Black Stars then again get possession. I mean, both teams seem very purposeless at this point, giving the ball away with a lot of careless abandon. So the Black Stars to Anan, who has had a very quiet game at left back, give it to Semenyo. Semenyo has dropped deep to look to find a lot more of the ball. Jordan looks to be playing ahead of him. That ball goes to Tariq Lamptey. Tariq Lamptey all the way to Forsen Amankwa, who's fitted in very nicely for Mohamed Abu. So the ball goes, it's a long, big boot forward. It's a big boot forward looking for Tariq Lamptey. Finds Ugandan boots, and the Black Stars of Ghana have won a free kick against the Cranes of Uganda. So there's a change, and El Capitano,
Long
Andre Morgan Rami Dede Ayew, all-time most appearances for the Black Stars, is coming on for none other than his brother, Jordan Ayew, Andre Rami Dede Ayew, who has just clocked 50 goals in the Ligue 1. He has been amazing for the Black Stars. I mean, he's starting off playing as a 17-year-old in 2008 under Claude Leroy. He has come a very long way. A couple of decades later, he's still a mainstay in this Black Stars team. Is he the one that is coming to inject what the Black Stars need with regards to impetus? We hope to see. So very soon, he will be coming on for his brother, Mohamed Salisu, on the ball. He finds Abdul Salis Ahmed in the middle of the park, and now it's looking very pedestrian from the Black Stars of Ghana, pinging the ball around very, very meticulously, very lackadaisically, until they move it forward. Anan, who does he find? Anan goes back, and the ball goes all the way back to Mohamed Salisu, who has taken a commanding presence. He goes very, very long to nobody in particular. That was a complete waste from Mohamed Salisu. And the Ugandans show him how it's done, playing the ball out from the back. That is an amazing pass. Is Ali Dusedu going to be able to mop it up? He does brilliantly. Ali Dusedu showing why Stade Rennais will go out there and pay 10 million euros just to secure his services. But then again, Otuado would also be thinking what he needs to do, not just to secure this result, but to secure the hearts and the sentiments of Ghanaians. Currently, the Black Stars are looking very ordinary against a very determined Cranes of Uganda, who are not going to let this game slide just like that. They are going to fight till their last blood.
Yeah, because I think that sometimes, even if you're a coach or if you're an ordinary supporter, I think people who really understand the game know that you can't win every game. You'll get upon a time where you will suffer defeat, but even you losing, they will just want to see the team put up a very good performance. They want to see that fighting spirit. And I think that we've not seen the Black Stars do that for a very, very long time, honestly. And I think that that is what most Ghanaians are expecting to see from these Black Stars. Yes, just like what I said in the second half.
Oh, I mean, that's surely a yellow card. That is surely a yellow card.
Yep.
Surely a yellow card. The Ugandans were on the charge. That was an amazing run from the center of midfield. And well, I think maybe because he just came onto the pitch, then again, it's going to get the benefit of the doubt. But then the Ugandans are stepping up in terms of tempo against the Black Stars of Ghana, who would look to at least double their tallies. 80 minutes played inside the Stade de Marrakech inside Morocco. The Black Stars of Ghana are 2 goals up against the one put behind the net by Steve Mukwala, who knows a thing or two about Ghana football. The Moroccans are going forward. The defense is still in sixes and sevens. Can they find their way through? They are looking for an incursion. The ball comes to the left. It's a deep cross in. Are they going to find the header? They do. And that hits the post. And oh my God, that is across the line, or is it? It is across the line. The Ugandans have found an equalizer. The Ugandans have found an equalizer, or have they not? Have they not? The referee has come to the aid of the Blacks. Is it a goal?
It's a goal.
Have they found an equalizer? Yes. The Ugandans have found an equalizer. But no, the referee is still remonstrating with the Black Stars. Yes, they have found an equalizer. The sloppiness of the Black Stars at the back has been punished. The Ugandans have found an equalizer. Andre Morgan Rami Dede Ayew is having a word with the referee. He doesn't seem to agree. But then again, that seemed like a very good goal from the Ugandans, who are relentless.
Sure.
They were testy. And they have found what they truly deserve, in what has been a second half dominated by them.
Because I was making this point earlier on before they started building up that particular attack. I think that, I mean, you look at it, it's a very sluggish play from the team because you don't have to give the ball away in your own 18-yard box. Even when you give the ball away, there was nobody to press the Ugandan player. They just watch the Ugandan player go pick up the ball, just make the cross. Nobody even challenged the striker. And I get the ball at the back of the net. It's a goal. You don't have to challenge. Just move on. And I was making this point of trying to see the Black Stars put up a fighting spirit. I don't think.
You can see the replay on your screens right now.
I think didn't really make that press good.
Now, guys, look, count the number of white shirts in the 18-yard
game
and compare that to just the red shirts.
Yeah.
You have just three red shirts.
Exactly.
Up against about six red and white shirts in the 18-yard box. Just count them.
Even at the board, even at the time, the crosswalk, just two Ugandan players.
No, just count the numbers.
Yeah.
I mean, just two Ugandan players.
Two Ugandan players in the 18-yard box.
Who came to the rescue? Of Wolokot after saving
After Wolokot saved, it was already saved, and I think it was too late.
Yeah. And that's something that if you count the number of white shirts in the 18-yard box, and I've been talking about this defense right from the very beginning of the game.
I mean, just starting from that clearance. I mean, clearly the Black Stars seem to be very tactically inept at this point. No tactical movement whatsoever.
After Jojo saved this, who was there to support?
I think Jerome was late. He was just more of like jogging.
He was caught ball watching.
Yeah, more of like he was just jogging, which is not good.
So the Black Stars have paid for it. Do they have what it takes to come back? Andre Didier-Ayew chases that. But then the Ugandans seem more hungry. The Cranes have sparked to life. They have sparked to life. They can smell blood with the Black Stars. They've seen that, listen, if we go out there and give our all, and we definitely will be able to beat this hapless, toothless, relentless Ghana team. So Abdul Salih Samir, the Black Stars seem to be playing with some form of urgency now, moving the ball from left to right. Tariq Lamptey, Ali Dusedu, what can he do? He turns around in the middle of the park, he looks forward, it's a long boot forward, but no, the Cranes of Uganda clear the ball. They are showing that, listen, they are cranes with long necks. Dig deep, they've dug deep, and this is their reward.
It's been coming. The second half has been very bad for the Black Stars.
It's true.
We didn't make any amends. We didn't push any ball forward.
I think the only positive thing that you can talk about for the Black Stars in the second half is that cross from Tariq Lamptey. And that has been, I think.
So the Black Stars are making forcing Amankwa, but no. I mean, that is an atrocious pass, to say the least. It looked very much like he passed that ball with his eyes closed. It looked very much like that. But then again, that is another back pass from the Black Stars. And you can see how relentless the Cranes have become, pressing the Black Stars in droves. Are they going to win the ball back? Ali Dusedu has given the ball away. As the Ugandans can smell blood at this point. They can smell the fragility of the Black Stars.
It's looking like anytime Ghana is playing and we don't score from a spot kick, we struggle to create our own chances to score. And I think it is something that Otuari really need to work on it. You need to work on the psyche of these players that, listen, you can't only win games through penalties. You need to, I mean, every good team, you look at the Barcelonas, the Real Madrid, the Manchester Cities, the Arsenals, they work their way out to score goals.
We have a set piece which was won out of nothing.
Gave it away.
So Mohamed Chaban, the goal scorer. Again, would the Black Stars be able to clear their lines? No, it is a corner kick. Yeah. It is a corner kick.
Because I mentioned that we have 15 minutes to end the game.
Yeah.
And if history should give us some form of guide, in the last three or so games we have played, we conceded in the last part of the game. 4 minutes, 2 minutes, 6 minutes to end of proceedings. And here we are. We couldn't solidify the lead. We couldn't hold on till the last breath of the game. Yeah. Now we're under pressure, intense pressure. We've barely 4 minutes to end. We've added on time.
Sure.
What will come out of this? The guys have scored from this sort of cross.
Yeah.
And it looks quite dangerous.
Yeah.
So the Black Stars in 60s and 70s again, as that set piece comes in, the Ugandans are creating their chances. Is it going to end up at the back of the net? That was another close shave for the Black Stars. And the Ugandans can smell the blood. They can feel the fragility in the Ghana national team. And they are doing everything, going every length to ensure that they exploit that fragility. Mohamed Salisu ever since he's come on, has struggled, Abdul Salih Samed, in the middle of the park. A lot of people are arguing that on social media that there's no creative spark within the team.
Yeah, that's true.
There's not a player who can pick out
the only player that way he can do that is Kudus, and he's not there. And I think that this time around, that's what I'm saying, that Otuado really need to work his way out to get some of these things done in the absence of some of his key players. Yeah, some of the players are in there. I was going to make a point. I mean, I think that's why I have this opinion about Ondrejo. We don't need Ondrejo in such games. We've seen Ondrejo and what he can do for this Black Stars. At this point, just allow those players to play. You bring him on, perhaps his first touch lead to something else.
Yeah, Uganda's winning another set piece in a dangerous position. And the Black Stars currently. There seems to have been a total capitulated. This is what they play. Well, some of the messages we can't read. Kets United clad in national colors, player agency. Wow, we have more messages on our console. Have you guys ever seen star that is black before? They are asking us, have you seen a star that is black before? There are a lot of messages coming through. I'd like to say a very good afternoon to Mr. Dominic Achampo, who is watching us live inside Ijisu constituency, Dominic Achampo, as well as Mr. Agbo Daya Bernard. Mr. Agbo Daya Bernard, a very good evening to you. So it's 89 minutes played at the Stade Marrakesh, and the Black Stars of Ghana, they are drawing 2-2 against their Cranes of Uganda. Ali Dusebi thought he could do it all by himself. But then again, there's a substitution. There is a substitution. Yeah,
Ibrahim Osman.
The player with jersey number 27, Ibrahim Osman.
FC Nordjylland player who is bound to join Brighton this summer.
Sahaku is coming out.
And a lot of people also argue he's the creative spark. Why did he not start?
Yeah, he's very good. He's very young. But just like what I said, these are young players that you need to integrate into the team properly. Now, 4 minutes at a time.
4 minutes for the Black Stars.
And it's dangerous.
Yeah.
Because again, 4 minutes could mean a lot. let's be cautious. 4 minutes could mean a lot. Because we seem to be under pressure from the Ugandans. I mean, the second 45 minutes has been so terrible. We failed to even possess the ball as we saw in the first half.
But then again, people also argue that, listen, it's a friendly. If you call players, why don't you, give everybody an opportunity?
Well, yeah, I agree with that. But the points that I earlier on made, these are young players. These are debutants.
But there are some young ones on the bench as well that people thought should have the opportunity.
Yeah, but then again.
Is that a penalty for the Black Stars? No, Antoine Semenyo is back on his feet.
But then again,
the Black Stars seem to be playing with more agency. Can they find that winning goal? Abdul Salih Samed on the ball, Tariq Lamte goes all the way back to Ali Dusebi, who has been lively since he came on. He wants to channel his inner Messi. Tariq Lamte with the cross, but there's nobody to connect to that cross.
Even though the ball was too much, though.
Not too much power.
The Ghanaians seem to be finding their rhythm. Now it's each one for himself. God for us all. The players are completely taking the bull by the horn. A lot of scramble, but the Ugandans seem more composed. There needs to be communication. They are pressing relentlessly. It's 4 minutes of added time, almost 2 minutes out of that 4 minutes played. The Black Stars have 2 minutes to finish this international break at least with a win.
Exactly. That's very important. Otuado need to win the hearts of Ghanaians, and it seems very difficult. You're losing to Nigeria and then against Uganda. This morning I heard somebody saying that we Ghana should beat Uganda no less than 5-0, and it has been difficult, honestly. And I think that
they've hardly had a shot on target,
especially in the second half, and that's something that Otuado need to work on. And I think as a team, just like what I said, it's going to take time, but I think that any player that Otuado brings into the national team, we need to see something very, very different. We need to see that hunger in each and every player. We need to see that fighting spirit in each and every player. But in two games, no wins, because it's going to be the talking point.
It's definitely going to be the talking point. Two games, no wins. And in this game, we have a very interesting stat. We have 3 shots, none on target.
That's serious. It's something which I don't need to...
No shots on target, Randy, in this particular game.
I'm not surprised.
Does this say anything about firepower? Tariq Lamptey, he is brought down. Tariq Lamptey has brought some firepower into this team.
Right? He's a very good player.
He's a very, very good player. At the right wing back where he's played. Can the Black Stars do something with this set piece? They scored both their goals from set pieces. One from a corner from Jordan Ayew. Now they have a free kick in a very dangerous position. And with just under a minute to go in this encounter, do the Black Stars have what it takes to go out there and pull the hazelnut out of the fire? Do they have what it takes to go out there and clinch it at the very last minute? Do they have what it takes to rescue this? Do they have what it takes to at least give Otuado an opportunity to start his reign with a win? Or Ghanaians will rain on them all the expletives that they can think about. It is Tariq Lamptey, the man who is probably from Labadi, who has to do this for the Black Stars. He's walking away from the ball. Tariq Lamptey is walking away from the ball. Who takes this free kick?
Why is the ball just there? Nobody's attending to it.
Well,
I think there is actually a temporal hold up. The referee probably calling for some others. Because Tariq was actually behind the ball when he moved back.
Wow.
This should be a very important kick for the Black Stars.
Definitely. Yeah.
Why not have someone with the left foot swing it this side instead?
Tariq Lamptey.
Maybe probably this has been rehearsed.
Exactly. Yep. Maybe from the training ground. The trainer scout must have rehearsed this with his team. So Tariq Lamptey behind the ball is going to be an in-swinger. Who's going to get his head to it? It's an in-swinger, but God. The Cranes stand tall once again. That's probably maybe the last kick of the game. The Cranes stand tall once again, and the Black Stars take it back. It's the 90th minute, but the Cranes are relentless in their running. It's a big boot forward. That is a very unfortunate slice. It's a throw into the Black Stars. Maybe the last throw of the dice for the Black Stars. It's now or never. This is very important. It is now or never. It's going to be a long one from Tariq Lamptey. It is a header in, but no. Just like this game has followed the script, it's been a very atrocious attacking rhythm from the Black Stars of Ghana. And there, ladies and gentlemen, goes the final whistle. The game ends at the Stade de Marrakech, and Otuado's charges were unable to get one against the Cranes of Morocco. It ends 2-2 at the start. Goals coming from Jordan Ayew for the Black Stars and Jerome Opoku as well. And for the Ugandans, Mohamed Shaban and Steve Mukwala made sure that they drew parity.
I think there's a confusion between Ali Dusadio and the match official. I think something happened before the free kick was taken by Tariq Lamptey. So you could see, if you watch the game carefully, Ali Dusadio was not on the pitch at that time. He was asked to stay off of the pitch. It was when after the free kick was taken then. So I think that Otuado is there talking to the match officials, Ali Dusadio. But I think I could see it has been a good game.
Definitely. Before you continue, we're having a lot of reactions. And people would like more reactions, right?
Sure.
So tonight at 7 p.m. exactly, the team will be here. Lukman is pumped up and heated. Sammy is heated. All of you should be heated as well, because tonight we are going in deep. So stay where you are tonight, 7 p.m. on the arena.
justified in this day and age when children do not have desks in schools, when children do not have textbooks? For 5 years, we've not provided our basic school children with textbooks, even though we've come out with a new curriculum, because we say there's no money. And you say we should use $450 million to build a cathedral. Even God will be angry with us.
Kamala Harris, she came with her husband, but to tell us that based on economical issues, that we should sign. If we sign next year, they will come for population. Who are they coming to count? You sit down to design policies on education for children's future, and you are denying people that they shouldn't give birth to children. Is God an animals, or we send it to the animals, this thing, for them to the forest to get animals to enter the school? These are logic things that a normal human being should understand. Yes, you don't need to go and sleep and wake up or dream of it before you sign the document. It's just a matter of black and white. Sign it and let it go. Because you yourself, you have children.
If you have a car and the driver didn't drive well, and so you are taking your car back, will you give it to your former experienced driver, or you give it to the careless driver's mate? I will give it to my former experienced driver. I will not give it to the driver's mate.
He shall be sworn in as a president, because we have realized and we have witnessed some administrations for the past. And then we have realized that we have to do the Sankofa way. Go back and pick His Excellency John Dramani Mahama.
If you do a comparative analysis of whoever has gone to a community and you want a direction back to the same community, you have no option than to ask the person who has been to that community before.
The victory of Mahama!